Drew and T head down to London's East End to meet a dealer with impressive credentials.
We're off to see Steve at Kemp London. And they are sign writers. Neons and rental, yeah. They are the oldest sign writers in London.
Fair play.
I like that. Bit of history.
Vintage signs are highly collectible. London is packed with thousands of examples, including the iconic underground station Roundels, which date back to 1908. Transport for London, the Barbican, and the City of London have all commissioned displays from Kemp London, makers of both neon and normal signs. In business since 1868, they're about to move from their two side-by-side stores in Hackney out to Essex. So current managing director Steve Earle is having a clear out.
I've got a love of vintage stuff anyway. I do tend to buy a lot of old vintage enamel signs that we upcycle, or we might put neon on the face of them. I just think we've probably got lots of items that may be of interest to him. He might have to twist my arm on certain items, you know, with regards to whether I want to sell them or not.
Prop houses that hire items to film and TV companies often make more money from rentals than sales, so Drew will have to pay good money to prize away Steve's best salvage.
Shall we have a look around?
Yeah, come in. Welcome to Kemp London.
Cool.
Yeah.
That's good. Salvage.
Yeah, nice. Aged steel letters, yeah.
Did you make all this?
Yeah, we do prop rental and prop hire.
Do you make signage for people as well for their shops, or is just hire?
No, we do a lot of bespoke pieces, you know. We do a lot of film work and props for TV events and photo shoots.
Tell you what, it's hot in here, isn't it?
It is very warm.
Is it me?
Yeah.
This all looks nice and finished. Have you got some stuff for us to have a look at?
Yeah, we've got some other stuff.
So, now you're talking.
Oh, here we go, Drew.
This is stuff for sale, then, is it?
Well, yeah, some of it's for sale, some of it's props, because some of it we rent out.
I tell you what, I really like that.
What, my Manchester sign?
Yeah. That predates some cat's eyes in the road, that type of sign.
Yeah. Unfortunately, really nice. That bit ain't for sale, Drew.
Oh, really?
It's amazing things. I'd never get another one of those.
No.
Ironically, it's pointing the wrong way as well.
Yeah, Manchester's that way.
Steve has worked here since the age of 16 in the mid-1980s. He took over the business from his father, who has kept up the family's signwriting talents in retirement.
I think this one you might be interested in, Drew.
Oh, look at that. That's literally got your name on it.
That is great.
Yeah, that was done by my dad. Yeah.
Your dad did this?
My dad did that, yeah. He's 84 and look at the sign.
That's pretty damn good.
That's pretty impressive,
good.
Isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah. Wow, that is really cool. So, can I buy that?
Absolutely. What are you going to give me for it?
Okay. About a handshake.
Yeah.
Cheers, thank you very much. His father has sign written it and signed it underneath. My father's a sign writer, my brother's a sign writer. So, you know, there's a real connection there. And to see the standard of what he's done there, it's very good. We leave that here and go on to somewhere else?
Yeah.
Next place?
Yeah.
There's some signs in the main shop that I'd look at. Wouldn't mind some prices on those.
So far, Drew's only purchase is the Remington sign. To make the trip worthwhile, he decides to revisit the first shop he went into.
Yeah, there's a couple of bits in here that I saw. The sex shop sign I like, and I did like it was that cross there.
I mean, that cross, I'd probably be looking about 1,200 quid for that. Sex shop neon, looking about 600 for that.
Neon gas powers these signs. It was first discovered in London in the 1890s, but it was at least a decade before it took off as a lighting source. It was first used in Paris in 1910 and got to America by 1923. With no restoration needed on the sign, Drew can sell it on exactly as he found it. It could be worth around £900.
Either really religious or really seedy signs sell very, very well. I bought and sold a sex shop sign not very long ago, only a few months ago. It sold the same day it went on the website, and I had several other people wanting it.
You're getting about 600 for that.
Is that all in VAT and everything?
Plus the VAT.
I was like quite happy at 500.
That's a bet, yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
Deal. Marvellous. Thank you very much. Bit of a giggle, isn't it? A bit
naughty. Yeah, it's seedy, isn't it?
It's not a new sideline you've got for Gav planned.
It's seedy. That's what we like. Yeah, it is. Yeah, we're going to hang that above the warehouse. Yeah. To be able to just walk in and buy a sign that is ready to go is much better for me. As time goes on, you know, we need to be buying things that there is no work to do because we have so much backed up restoration work that we just can't cope with it. Cool, right then, let's get the van, it's boiling in here, and let's get that out of here. Excellent, love it. Best buy of the day, well, actually, to be honest, both of them are in two different ways. The Remington sign for its complete originality, colour, and condition, and then the sex shop sign because there's absolutely no work to do and we can sell it immediately and it will sell quickly at a profit.
Yeah, all in all, it's been an eventful day and made a bit of money as well.
All right.
Yeah.
All in. Marvellous. Thanks very much. Right, pleasure.
Thanks for coming down, boss.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Yeah, brilliant. Awesome. Cheers.
Cheers. Yeah. Bye.